Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Good morning, and welcome to our worship this fifth Sunday after the Epiphany. This worship service is offered to the glory of God and in prayer for healing for those who are ill and for those who are searching for Christ. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
The first lesson, a reading from the book of Isaiah. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is He who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spread them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He He who brings out their hosts and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard the Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth? He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us all read the response, Psalm 147. Hallelujah! How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor him with praise. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He counts the numbers of the stars and calls them all by their names. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to his wisdom. The Lord lifts up the lowly, but cast the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God upon the harp. He covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain for the earth. He makes grass to grow upon the mountains and green plants to serve mankind. He provides food for flocks and herds and for the young ravens when they cry. He is not impressed by the might of a horse. He has no pleasure in the strength of a man. But the Lord has pleasure in those who fear him, in those who await his gracious favor. Hallelujah.
The second lesson. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. If I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me, and woe to me, if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this on my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation, I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the Jews, I became as a Jew in order to win Jews. To those under the law, I became as one under the law. Though I myself am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law, I became as one outside the law. Though I am not free from God's law, but am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak, I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue at Capernaum and entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place. And there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, the Creator, the Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My dear friends, preaching, healing, and prayer. These actions are embedded into the life of Jesus as he shared the inbreaking of God's presence in the world. The gospel authors recorded contents of Jesus' preaching, healing various illnesses and spending lots and lots of time alone to pray. In today's story from Mark, Jesus enters the house of Simon and Andrew. He heals Simon's mother-in-law. And at sundown, people start gathering around him. Jesus heals various illnesses and casts out demons. But in the morning, Jesus is gone from their sight. He goes to a deserted place and prays. This time, people are looking for him. "Everyone is searching for you," the disciples told Jesus. I wonder why they are looking for Jesus. And I wonder what do people really want from him. Likewise, I wonder why we continue searching and looking for Jesus. What is it that we want from him? Experiencing the presence and power of Jesus makes a big, big difference. Jesus enters Simon's house, and surely he enters our houses too. Things happen, things change. I have heard from many people sharing stories on how happy they were when they felt Jesus entering their houses. Testimonies like revealing a diagnosis having changed for no apparent medical reason. Stories about experiences of calmness, of peace that are attributed to Jesus' presence. Stories about unexpected reconciliation happening between two people having a long, long time animosity. People cry with joy and gladness when they share about their moments closest to Jesus' experiences. These are real. Jesus is present and active in the world. Perhaps these are the reasons why people start to line up at the door where Jesus was. Jesus' presence is felt and is real. Results are visible, tangible. All is great and well. And faith, my dear friends, and commitment are quite easier when things are all okay and smooth. However, the following morning, Jesus was gone, and they searched for him. Like the fox in Capernaum, the northern city in the Sea of Galilee, we too search for Jesus. I wonder, however, what happens when life seems bleak and dark? When things happen when we never wanted to happen? When life is just hard? When we do not get results the way we wanted to? When times seem to be all darkness and Jesus could nowhere to be found? What do we do when Jesus seems staying away and we feel alone, so helpless? My dear friends, we need to pray. Jesus goes to a deserted place and prays. I think it is not about Jesus abandoning the people in need, but it is about prayer. Jesus' prayer and our own prayer. Prayer, as noun, is defined as a spiritual communion with God. It is the process by which our understanding of what God calls good increases. Jesus prays a lot. Not because Jesus needs something, but because he wants always to be in constant communion with the Father. And we are invited to do the same. We pray to be equipped with the power to follow his will. Jesus has promised that he will be with us till the end of time. He may be out of our sight, but it does not mean he is absent. His seeming withdrawal is an invitation for us to move to a new place, to a new space, to a deserted space where we are all alone with the alone in prayer. Here, with our participation and openness, we are restored to new life and is resolved to follow his holy will. My dear friends, we all have deserted spaces in our lives. It is where we have to accept that we have limitations, and sometimes things are beyond our control. It is where we have to confront ourselves with our brokenness, with our loneliness, with our grief, financial difficulties, and issues of our health are just some examples that we have to deal. We tend to escape and avoid from these spaces, but it is in this realm that we have to face who we are and who we are not. It is in these deserted places that our deepest healing and restoration can take place, can happen. Here we are in prayer with God. According to one author, and I quote, "The deserted places of our lives are the starting points for the message of the good news to penetrate our innermost being and allow ourselves to be healed. In here, we learn to recognize that ultimately our efforts, our possessions, Our successes and accomplishments do not count as much. Rather, peace and love in relation with God and one another count the most. Experiencing this remarkable grace, my dear friends, we start to preach the good news through our lives in living the way of love, healing people by seeing God in us, and praying with one another, commune with God. There is nothing in the desert but only God. In prayer, Jesus is drawing us deeper and closer into the mind and heart of God. Jesus is there praying with us, praying for us, and praying for the world. There is a saying that goes, when we work, but when we pray, God works. I wonder why and where we look for Jesus. What and how do we say when we pray or gather together for worship? Like at this very moment, do we flood Jesus with our needs and wishes and wants? There is nothing wrong with this because Jesus tells us to ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and it will be opened unto you. But please remember, Jesus said this at the Sermon on the Mount, and it was said in a context that what we ask for must be good according to God's will. In prayer, we cultivate a desire for us to seek what is objectively good. Surely Jesus cares for our needs and concerns, especially of healing and restoration. But let us be aware that this story that we just heard today, the fifth Sunday after Epiphany, a story which is a reminder that it may be, or a reminder of the possibility of looking for Jesus because we want him to enter into our own personal agenda and ambitions, rather than allowing ourselves to listen to his words and follow him. Let us not make Jesus a servant of our plans, a servant of our wishes, and a servant of our ambitions. So like the others, we all are searching for Christ. Let us all be challenged to value, desire, and seek God's kingdom above everything else, and continue to look for places and spaces where we may find Jesus and settle ourselves in communion with him and prayer. Thus, his presence shall heal and restore us to who we are as followers of Christ. My dear friends, in Jesus, we find forgiveness, we find acceptance, we find hope and security with God. Amen.
Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people. We give thanks for the blessing our congregation has received and for the continued financial support from the diocese, our pledgers and givers. For God's blessing on those who celebrate their birthdays this week, especially Nina Braun Roman Torres, Primo Castaneda, Jennifer Perganen, Edna Flores Lagonte, Aaron J. David, Tess Tesorero, Paul Abuda, Leslie Canoy, those whom we now name silently or aloud. We say special thanks for prayer for the intentions of Kevin Scott Abarquest El Mario. We give thanks for those who celebrate their wedding anniversaries this week, especially and those whom we now name silently or aloud. We continue to pray for the health of Craig Tronoff, Elsie Chang, Marietta Flores, Rosalia Bassa, Maha Milanis, Romy Miharis, Mayette Garcia, Grace Carlin, Vic and Astrid Aguliana, Pasita Dascu, Isabel Marcela Romel Lulukisen, Marcelino Guillermo Jr., Elizabeth Reese, Juana K. Pailano, and those whom we may now name and silently aloud. We pray for the repose of the soul of the departed, especially Bishop Marcelino Guillermo Sr., Segundina Yang, Tomasita Perganen, Merlina Dimatulak, and those whom we may now name silently or aloud. We pray for the governments of all nations of the world that they may have wisdom and foresight in dealing with the worldwide health crisis we are now facing. We pray for all the medical personnel and first responders that they be guided by your mercy and grace as they work to ensure our safety and well-being. We pray for all government workers, sanitation workers, grocery store personnel, emergency transport and response team, and all those who faithfully provide essential services during this time. We pray for all who are ill with COVID-19 and ask for restoration of health. We pray for the victims of natural calamities and inclement weather. Keep our emergency responders in safety, the fire department, the police department, our medical frontliners, the community, and all other responders.
We also offer healing prayers for Cassie Santos, Nestor Regino, Julia Regino, Mary Ferrer.
We pray for all those who are unemployed because of the pandemic and for those who face economic uncertainties. We pray for those who are most vulnerable among us, the homeless, the poor, the elderly, the mentally ill. Give us heart of compassion to care for them in their need. And Lord, we pray for all who suffer fear, anxiety, loneliness, or depression during this difficult time. Help them to know that you are God and will never leave or forsake them. We give thanks to you, O God, for your love that will never leave us and for our precious connections with others. We thank for the hope and that is still your beautiful world. Most of all, we thank for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who has conquered sin, evil, and death forever, and who comes to bring us abundant life, hope, and joy.
Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray, not as we ask in our ignorance, nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Beloved in the Lord, we are the body of Christ. In one spirit, we were all baptized into one body.
Let us strive to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Virtual hugs to all. Welcome. We
peace
love
to
you.
All.
Peace, joy.
Peace to you.
Peace. In all things that I have shown you that by so toiling, one must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." Let us with gladness present the offerings of our life and work to the Lord. And we give thanks to all of our pledgers and givers and donors.
I shall give you rest. Take
Let us all join now in the doxology.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
God of life and freedom, we celebrate the revelation of Jesus as Christ, who makes all creation new. Accept all we offer you this day and make us new in him who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
O God of creation, you are always with us. You breathe among us. You unite us in your love. And so we praise you and we bless you.
We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, God Most High.
Your Son Jesus finds each separate heart. He gathers us together. He welcomes us all into communion. And so we praise and bless you.
We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, God Most High.
Show us gathered here that we too are Christ's body, joined to all your human family throughout the ages. In your love, feed us, inspire us, fill us with Christ's life that we may fill our lives with you. Make this sharing radiant with your presence and send us out into the world to shine forth your truth. All this we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And now in the language of our hearts and as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
and the glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. And now, because we are not able to share physically in the sacrament, we will all join in spiritually in our connection in the body of Christ. I'm saying together the prayer for spiritual communion. In union, dear Lord, with the faithful at every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are being offered to the Father, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I believe that you are truly present in the Holy Sacrament, and since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I entreat you to come spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all the affections of my soul. Let me never be separated from you. Let me live and die in your love.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
And now in thanksgiving, let us pray together the post-communion prayer. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, we thank you because you have accepted us as living members of the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have nourished us with the sacrament of his victorious life. May we be bread broken and given for the world. May your love in us heal the wounds we have made. May your words on our lips speak peace to all people. Send us with vision and courage to love and serve your Son, Jesus Christ, and your people. And so will your name be praised and glorified, now and in time to come, until all be fulfilled in your kingdom.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Before we're dismissed, I'd like to make some announcements. First of all, Ash Wednesday is coming up real soon on February 17th. And we are reflecting on some of the guidelines of the diocese and some of the changes that may be necessary because of the pandemic. But we will have full announcements about how that service will be next Sunday, the 14th. Also in our common life, just to remember for Bishops Committee members, there's a meeting of the Bishops Committee on Sunday, February 21st at 1. And then for all of us, our annual meeting will be Sunday, February 28th. It will be part of our service, and there'll be more details coming on that, but it's a time for us to celebrate our common life, to give thanks to God, and to pray for discernment for our ministry in the future.
Thank you very much, Rebecca. Also, thank you to our pianist for this Sunday service, Kevin Scott Abarquez Almario. Thank you very much. Thank you for Angela Candlas, our soloist, to Edda for reading the second reading, and to Hannah B for the first reading and for her expertise in our technical setup. And also to Mark, thank you so much for being with us and reading the prayers of the people. And to all, to the family of Father Leonard for singing with us today. To our food runner volunteers headed by Dr. Ron Mitchell, Mario Derrit, Lito Parangan, Liuel Pailano, Mary Chow, and other volunteers, thank you to all. And this coming Saturday, February the 13th, one day before Valentine's Day, the men of our, the Brotherhood of St. Martin, we are going to do clean up in our yard, in our grounds. So if you have time to be around, please come about 9 a.m. on Saturday and join us, of course, with mask and social distancing, doing mowing and other cleaning this Saturday. So thank you in advance. Likewise, I would like to ask some members of our congregation, the team that would be coming on Saturday will be doing cleaning and maybe sort things up and try to sort out some things in our space. So if you remember that you have some personal items that are here, please come and take them, because we don't want to throw or to sort out things that are personally owned. So please give me a call at 650-636-5654 if you have some things that need to be taken back by you. So once again, on Saturday, February the 13th, at 9 o'clock here at church, we are going to do cleanup, yard mowing, cutting, and other activities for the maintenance of our church. So again, thank you, Mark and Ed, for cleaning and doing maintenance also inside the church. And to all of you who join us in our worship today, thank you so much. Enjoy the football game, the Super Bowl, this afternoon. I don't want to make a guess who would win.
And thank you also to Father Urich for that inspiring message. That gives us food for thought all week. That was lovely. Thank you.
Go in peace. Thank you. You're welcome. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Continue searching Jesus, especially in the deserted spaces of your life. You'll always find him loving and healing.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are